Well, we've seen DePaul, especially in their last two games, have scoring droughts where against Wichita State. I believe it was a 16-0 run in the first half. They had a similar drought against Texas in the second half. Now those free throws maybe give them a little bit momentum closing out the first half here.
Malcolm Duvivier running the point now in the backcourt with Roberto Nelson. Jarmal Reed, Devon Collier, and Daniel Gomez, the five on the floor for Oregon State. Shot rattles out. Look at that Gomez go get it. This guy, he's got some energy.
You called it, though. You've had something taken away from you for 2 years, and you get the chance to get back on the floor, you're going to make the most of it.
Broken leg and then rehabbing that broken leg. Leaving Gomez on the sidelines two straight seasons. Closing in on the two-minute mark. Garrett, good move to free himself along the baseline, sets up Crockett. Garrett, offensive rebound. Oh, that looked like that could have been goaltending. Nothing calm. That ball was coming off the glass when it was knocked away.
That was an awkward-looking play for sure.
Nelson skips it over Duvivier. Reed has his pocket picked by Melvin. Young in transition. And DePaul can't cash in.
Young was simply trying to draw contact there, Eric. There's no way he's going to be able to make that shot.
Oregon State down by two. They could tie it or take the lead on this possession. Minute and a half remaining, first half. Collier's been quiet for a while. That's the first jumper we've seen. He's now got 22 points. Make it 24 points for Collier.
And Collier now, it's too late. Marchuch battling with foul trouble. He can't play him tight. Now Collier just taking whatever the defense gives him.
Tied at 39. 1 minute remaining, first half. Young step back jumper, gets his own miss, spins inside, sets up Garrett. Oh, the freshman, just when DePaul needed it most. 3 points, he's got five.
Besides that last attempt at the rim by Brandon Young, I've been impressed with his decision making, trying to get his teammates involved. That was a good job off of a miss to come and look for his teammate.
Nelson splits the double team, sets up Duvivier. That was a clank shot. And now DePaul with the shot clock off can hold it if they want. Instead, Young forces the issue and he's fouled.
Watch Brandon Young. This is off of an offensive rebound from his own miss. Does a good job of sucking in the defense on the penetration. Finds his freshman teammate in the corner.
Young 4 for 5 at the free throw line. He'll shoot two.
You know, Eric, this freedom of movement that the NCAA has adopted with the emphasis on the rules changes and trying to promote scoring has pretty much taken defense out of the basketball game. And it's a shame because defense was 50% of the game before this year. But now it's next to impossible to draw a charge because you have to be in legal guarding position before the movement of the ball occurs. That's next to impossible. And so, yes, the scoring's up, but defense has really taken a hit as a result.
And we've got both teams shooting well over 50% so far here in our first half, and we're having scores that will probably finish in the 80s when it's all said and done. So the scoring is definitely up. Nelson, wild shot. Rebounded Duvivier. And that'll do it for our first 20 minutes here in Rosemont, Illinois. The locals heading into the locker room feeling good about themselves. Oliver Purnell's Blue Demons leading Oregon State 43-39 here at the break. And it's been a fun first half to watch, expecting good things in the second half. All right, after these messages, we'll head back to Los Angeles for a Fox College Hoops halftime update.
Champions presents the WWE Live Holiday Tour. Don't miss your chance to see all your favorite superstars, including CM Punk, Daniel Bryan, Randy Orton, Ryback, the Wyatt family, and more. It's the WWE Live Holiday Tour in Chicago, December 26th. Tickets and VIP packages are available. Go to WWE.com for more information.
Fans are dedicated spirit squad. Share their skills with our young fans. Our junior Blue Demon cheerleaders and dancers will now showcase what they have learned today. Put your hands together for the 2013 DePaul Spirit Clinic performers.
Yeah.
A lot of offense in our first half. Both teams shoot well over 50%. And DePaul trying to snap a two-game losing streak. They lead at the break over Oregon State. Stephen Bardo, I'm Eric Collins. Let's get right down to it. That offense coming from one particular guy for Oregon State.
Yeah, he really kept them in the ball game. You thought it would be Roberto Nelson, one of the nation's leading scorers, but it was Devon Collier who really carried this ball club until the rest of his teammates caught up. And what you notice about these highlights, Eric, everyone is at the rim. And so DePaul's got to make some adjustments and try to keep Collier away from the rim, be a double team, or play behind him and make him score over the top. And then for DePaul, Brandon Young was fantastic, not only on the defensive end where he did a great job on Roberto Nelson, but he was really aggressive at getting his shot. Three and ones for the young man from Baltimore.
DePaul as a team, they shoot 53%. Oregon State, not too shabby, they shoot 52%. Not a lot of three-pointers made, just five combined between the two schools. And turnovers, dead even.
Interesting that the stat sheet almost mirrors one another. And 15 to 29 from the field was Oregon State, 15 to 28 from the field was DePaul. But both teams understand that they can get shots and scoring opportunities in the paint, and they've been very patient.
Fade away, Hamilton. Offensive rebound, Melvin short-armed it, but got it back. Just padding the rebounding total there.
Yeah, it is 4-5-4, Moses Malone invitation. Try to get some more boards there.
That's now 11 points for Cleveland Melvin. Backdoor cut, and that's going to be an offensive foul. That's conflicting calls. Our two officials, it looked like we were going to have a block, but instead we got a charge call.
And I think they got it right. It looked like Billy Garrett Jr. was in correct position.
Okay, now they're conferring with each other. The two conflicting calls made by the officials at the scorer's table right now. One official calling a block, the other one calling the charge.
And so it's interesting that before this season, the default call when there was a bang-bang play was there was a charge, right? So look at Billy Garrett Jr. He's in good legal guarding position before the movement of the ball takes place. Let's take a look at it again. Right there, he's set. I thought that was a good call.
And they're going to keep it as an offensive foul on Victor Robbins. So no basket. Robbins' first foul. DePaul up by six. At one point in the first half, DePaul up by 12. That was at the 7:29 mark.
Cleveland Melvin. A little bit more patience. He had Thomas Hamilton wide open at the Big East emblem mark in the paint.
Marchuch over to Young. Shot clock down to seven. Young turns the corner, flips it up with the left hand, and it spills out. Now Nelson, fairly quiet in the first half, on the run out. Blocked from behind by Young.
Great pursuit getting back defensively, not allowing Garrett to stay on an island by himself.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah, there's some lingerie left on the deck right there. Earl Nelson, now you see me, Billy Garrett, now you don't.
Stationary jumper, Angus Brandt hits the three-pointer. And now we'll have a conversation. Collier and Hamilton being brought together and making sure that they're simpatico.
I like this because you don't see this enough in college basketball especially. See two guys starting to get a little bit more physical. Tommy Hamilton, a freshman, trying to take some of the urgency defensively to slow down Collier.
Cleveland Melvin's really worked on that shot in the offseason, and it's paying dividends. He's got 14 points. Melvin already with 14 three-pointers through the first seven games, had 15 the entire season a year ago. One and done for the Beavers. Young the other way, scores on the reverse.
I tell you what, Billy Garrett set that up. Billy Garrett Jr. keeping his head up, finding Young where he could do something with it. Nice job by the freshman playmaking.
Grant bottled up by a wall of Blue Demons and goes right through. How'd that happen?
Sandy Marchuk's not wanting to pick up another foul. Wasn't too aggressive there defensively.
5 points for Brant all here in the second half. And Marchuk's main backup, Peter Rickbosch, has actually got more fouls than Marchuk does. Rickbosch has three, and Melvin hits the deck hard.
Watch Billy Garrett keep his head up, looking down the floor, probing, then hits Young in stride. He doesn't have to do anything but put it on the deck and get to the rim. Nice tandem work by the guards from DePaul.
Couple of free throws for the senior from Baltimore. First time Cleveland Melvin's at the free throw line this afternoon.
And Cleveland Melvin played a lot of four early in his career. DePaul, with the added size on the front line of Marchuk and Tommy Hamilton, able to come out a little bit more in his natural position of small forward wing. And his game has reflected the work that you talked about in the offseason here.
Melvin closing in on 1,600 career points. He's got 16 here against Oregon State. Lead is now 8 for DePaul. Last time DePaul and Oregon State played, Ray Meyer was in his third year as a head coach here at DePaul. Martin's jumper no good.
Paul looking to get out, look for those early opportunities in the shot clock.
Tough little floater there. Garrett hits it from 6 feet. He was going about 40 miles an hour, stopped on a dime, and had feathery touch.
And he doesn't look like a freshman. He just plays with so much poise.
That's a tough pass. Nelson trying to lead Grant to the basket, and the pass sails out of bounds.
Watch the floater up fake, freezes the defense, avoids the charge, the floater along the baseline. Billy Garrett Jr., one of two players to get their jersey retired. The other, Wayne Blackshear at their high school, Morgan Park, here in Chicago. Billy Garrett Jr. was a point guard on their state title team his junior season. So this young man is used to winning and plays much above his freshman classification.
Oh, a little ticky-tack foul, Jarmal Reed. He had a hand right there on the waist of Cleveland Melvin. It's going to be two free throws. Now there is Billy Garrett Sr. He's a guy who's been a college assistant coach a number of different places. He was at Seton Hall in years past. Now entrenched in Oliver Purnell's staff.
And you know, I'm a father of two sons, and it would be very difficult to be a coach with your son on the team because you want so much for them, but you want to treat them no different than anyone else. And so that's a difficult balance between those two, but they seem to handle it very, very well. Maybe called Greg McDermott.
Oh, goodness.
He and Doug McDermott.
Grant squares up against Melvin, and we'll have a foul. Who's this one going to be on? It's on Cleveland Melvin for sticking his knee out, trying to impede the progress of Angus Brant. First foul on Melvin.
Angus Brant was so surprised that they gave him a shooting foul. He was walking around trying to get in position. They finally had to put him on the line.
Substitution for DePaul. Jamie Crockett's going to get his first second half playing time. He replaces Cleveland Melvin.
Talk about a great doubleheader right there. UNC coming back, struggling. Lost at home to Belmont to come back and beat Louisville. So the ups and downs of early season in college basketball.
Crockett over to Young. Hamilton from distance, that's a three-pointer. 12 points. Hamilton joining Young and Melvin in double figures. Nelson turns the corner, hangs, and hits it off the window. Quick timeout called by Oregon State. 10 points now for Roberto Nelson. He averages 27. Tommy Hamilton, the fourth, showing you what all the excitement's about. A three-pointer for DePaul. The USC returns to Fox Sports 1 and Fox Sports 2 this week, beginning on Thursday with weigh-ins on Fox Sports 2. Then Friday is another USC Fight Night, beginning with the pre-fight show, followed by prelims, and then UFC Fight Night featuring bouts between Mark Hunt and Bigfoot Silva and Shogun versus Tahuna. Fox Sports 1 and Fox Sports 2 are your homes for UFC action. Tommy Hamilton. 284 pounds, can rip the triple. Last three games, 5 of 6 from behind the arc.
That's why the DePaul staff is so excited. They've got an inside-outside combo with Garrett and Hamilton. For years to come, they are stellar players, and you know they're productive right now.
Garrett has his pocket pick, but DePaul gets it right back. Crockett with the steal. Young loses the handle. And this is an official's timeout. We'll get it all sorted out for you when you get back to Allstate Arena here in Rosemont. DePaul trying to hold on. They've got a 10-point lead, 57-47 on top of Oregon State. DePaul on top of Oregon State by 10, and December 1st is a very important day in DePaul basketball history. Who remembers this? December 1st, 1980, on the cover of Sports Illustrated, that came out on that day. Mark Aguirre, left-hand part of your screen, in the middle, Ralph Sampson out of Virginia, and Albert King, Bernard's younger brother at Maryland. That was December 1st, 1980. Also on December 1st, 1980, DePaul playing their first game here at Allstate Arena. At that time, it was called the Rosemont Horizon. DePaul winning, going away against Gonzaga, a Gonzaga team that had John Stockton in the backcourt. Of course, DePaul was loaded. Those DePaul teams had Mark Aguirre, Terry Cummings, Bernard Randolph.
Teddy Grubbs.
Skip Diller.
Skip Diller, loaded.
And DePaul, when they opened up December 1st, 1980, they were the number one ranked team in the country. All right, this is what the officials are looking at. Trying to figure out what the shot clock should look like. The ball was poked loose from Brandon Young and was kind of moving around in the backcourt. They've decided that there should be 33 seconds on the shot clock. At least that's what's on there right now. Okay, they're still looking, I apologize. They're still looking at the shot that you're looking at home.
And it appears as though it should be 11. Maybe they're even looking at the game clock.
Yeah, there was never any definitive possession for Oregon State.
We'll get it all sorted out here shortly. It looks like they're coming to some consensus.
Okay, so they did reset the shot clock. They did say that Oregon State had the ball long enough to constitute a possession. So there's 31 seconds now on the shot clock. We're playing basketball once again. Stephen Bardo, I'm Eric Collins here in Rosemont, Illinois. DePaul and Oregon State playing for the first time since December 1945, when a guy by the name of George Mikan was in uniform for Ray Meyer's Blue Demons. George Mikan, for those not familiar, was considered the first superstar in the college game.
And then went on to, I believe, play at the Minneapolis Lakers.
Yeah. The reason why the Los Angeles Lakers are the Lakers, because they played in Minneapolis, a lot of lakes.
And you know what? You know you were good when they named a drill after the Mikan drill.
Oh, sure. I've done that.
Oh, yeah.
Little half hooks of the right hand, a little half hook of the left hand.
That's right. Something Chris Mullen really worked on to become one of the best players to ever play the game. He loved the Mikan drill.
Now the foul's starting to accumulate for Devon Collier. That is now his third personal foul. Collier, who had 22 points in the first half, has not scored here in the second half.
And I understand coach being very confident in his players, but you got well over 14 minutes left in the game. I'd be very cautious to keep Collier in the game.
Garrett misses the three-pointer. Oregon State down by 10. And Hamilton with the rip away. Good steal by the freshman big man. Garrett gets inside, finds Dunn, scores!
Billy Garrett Jr. once again, threading the needle, going through the defense, finding Brandon Young. They are on a rope together. Just a beautiful tandem.
Now we're gonna have a foul defensively on DePaul. They call it on Hamilton.
You see Billy Garrett slows down, picks up the pace. Three defenders come to him. Brandon Young keeps running because he knows Garrett can find him. Look at Brandon Young pick up speed right there. Beautiful execution by DePaul, two-man basketball.
Garrett starting for the first time, last time DePaul played. This is going to be a foul, a push-off on Nelson, trying to create space on that inbounds pass.
I tell you what, Brandon Young is really frustrated Roberto Nelson this afternoon. Picking up offensive fouls. We saw him on that fake three-point shot attempt where he was trying to get create contact in the first half and force a turnover. So, you know, one of the nation's leading scorers, very frustrated thus far.
Crockett is bumped off course, can't hit the shot, but an offensive rebound. Mark Juge and Collier now. That's his first basket of the second half. 24 points for Collier.
Eric, I'm like you. He's listed at 216. Let's call him about 230, 235.
Oliver Purnell, hoping that this big lead doesn't slip away, calls a timeout for the Blue Demons.
Looks like Crockett on a tough shot. Marchuch had the right idea, was off balance. Collier read it the whole way. Big fella, he's showing some nice anticipation.
So DePaul, two straight losses, taken on a hot team in Oregon State. Oregon State lost their opener against Coppin State, but then ripped off three straight wins, beating Portland, the Pilots, knocking down the Terrapins, Maryland, in College Park, Maryland. President Barack Obama was in attendance. And also beating Southern Illinois at Edwardsville. So Oregon State 3-1, taking on the DePaul team at 3-3, DePaul losing a pair of games against Wichita State and Texas during the past week.
So if you think, if you're playing on a team and your coach is the brother-in-law of the President of the United States, and you go and play in Maryland, you think you got a little motivation there? Oregon State is 4-0 in front of Barack Obama.
They have not lost.
So they might want to schedule a game out in the D.C. area against UCLA or one of the Pac-12 behemoths.
Still having some clock issues here at Allstate Arena. It's been squared away. 13:41 remaining. DePaul up by 10 on Oregon State. DePaul's going to be all Pac-12 all the time this week. Their next game will be Friday right here at Allstate Arena against the Arizona State Sun Devils. That's going to be a fun one to watch.
Sure is. The Sun Devils have one of the best point guards in the nation, Jahi Carson. It's fun to watch, and will give DePaul everything they can handle on the perimeter.
Marchuch fouled inside. He was grabbed by Daniel Gomez, and Marchuch will go to the free throw line. Second foul on Gomez.
That offensive possession was reminiscent of DePaul in the first half, when they had very good ball movement. They were very patient and got the ball inside. It's like DePaul, after that timeout, got regrouped offensively and good execution.
Sonny Marchuch, the Purdue Boilermaker transfer, will shoot two free throws. Marchuch was coached in high school by Delray Brooks, former McDonald's All-American, Michigan City Rogers High School. All right, this is what DePaul has upcoming. Got a game against Arizona State on Friday right here on Fox Sports 1. Florida Atlantic, Chicago State locally, Houston Baptist, and then the Redbirds of Illinois State December 22nd. Trying to get ready for the new version of the Big East.
It ought to be really interesting. Villanova beating Iowa in overtime last night to win the battle for Atlantis. So Villanova has wins over Kansas and Iowa.
Iowa's going to be good this year, too. That's a great win for Jay Wright's team.
That's exactly right. And St. John's, maybe the most talented team in the Big East. Struggling a little bit here.
Ball loose on the floor, picked up by Marchuch. He's been a magnet for loose balls this afternoon. And this is going to be Oregon State basketball. You're talking about the energy in the first half here in the building. Seems like it may have picked up a little bit here in the second half. Guys are flying all over.
Yeah, and they understand it. This is a wonderful opportunity here. Brandon Young losing the handle a little bit, but you like the effort from the senior. You know, he's trying to save the basketball. That resonates to the rest of his teammates, but you need to be out here laying it on the line as well.
Oregon State having no luck at all getting it inside to Collier here in the second half. Forced to take a jumper. That's off the mark, but look at the big paw of Gomez tapping it back in. Just a huge wingspan. Able to get his fingertips on that ball and tap it in.
And a really good athlete for his size.
And another poke away. Oregon State basketball, 4-on-2. They cash in. Nelson, two more points for him. He's got a dozen.
This Oregon State team is tops in the Pac-12 in scoring, so they can score in bunches last season. So they can hit you, and Paul seemed to have trouble with this 1-3-1 until then.
Marchuch gets two back for the Blue Demons. 9 now for the graduate student.
If If I'm Brandon Young, Sandy Marchuch, Melvin Cleveland, I take Billy Garrett Jr. out to dinner before the night before each game. He's got his waiter's apron on. He's setting them up beautiful.
Young and Melvin. And this is going to be a blocking foul called on Oregon State. Roberto Nelson continues to be frustrated with the fouls that he continues to accumulate. DePaul riding the freshman Garrett. Plenty of nice passes from him. .34 remaining in this one. DePaul trying to snap a two-game losing streak, taking on a red-hot Oregon State team, winners of three in a row. But DePaul, they've got themselves a comfortable 9-point lead, and maybe even more comfortable the fact that Roberto Nelson, sitting on the bench right now, just picked up his fourth foul. Roberto Nelson coming into this one averaging 27 points per game.
Well, and he's obviously upset because he appeared to have really good defensive position, and now with four fouls, down 9 points on the road, and Collier really slowed here at the beginning of the second half, not nearly as active as he was in the first half. A lot of pressure on he and Angus Brandt to pick up the scoring output for Oregon State.
Collier just had one field goal here in the second half, and that came on a ball that was poked away, and he had himself a fast break dunk. That's it in the first 8.5 minutes. Brandon Young's been a fixture at the free throw line. Young now is 6-for-8 shooting free throws. He's got 16 points. Steven, it seems like these veteran players who understand the way this game's being officiated this year really taking advantage by going to the line a whole bunch and getting some cheap points that way.
Exactly right. Throwing the body, making contact. Anytime they're in position to score, if they can draw contact, they know that they'll get to the line. And that's the easiest way for scorers to get on track. See those free throws go in psychologically, just does wonders for their confidence.
Illegal screen set by number 12, Angus Brandt. He's now got 3 personal fouls. Greg Robinson looking for answers. His team is shooting 52% in today's game, 54% here in the second half. But they just can't cut into this lead for DePaul. They're still down by double digits.
Well, and they're giving up 55%, almost 56% themselves. And so, you know, offense sells tickets, but defense wins championships. And if you're not, if you can't get stops, especially on the road, it's difficult to come from behind.
Garrett inside, left-handed layup.
I'm telling you, this young man has the makings of a star here at DePaul.
He's got 9 points to go with 6 assists.
Poised, makes the right play most of the time. You don't see him get frustrated easily.
And a steal for Young. And Young, the blow by, makes the layup. Hallis Cook with an ole, letting Young go right to the rim.
It looked like Brandon Young hurt himself. He was calling for somebody to come in for him, grimacing a little bit. See him walking towards the bench. And I thought the defender would be hurting because he just crossed him up so nasty right there. Left him at the before the rim. Easy layup.
Yeah, they're going to take Brandon Young out of the game.
Looked like his left ankle. He may have turned on that plant.
So Young now at the end of the DePaul bench being looked at. He's replaced by Darrell McDonald. Grant bottled up along the baseline, and we've got a bump. Foul called on DePaul.
Angus Brandt's got to score the basketball right there at 6'10". You can't be looking for an interior pass. You've got to go up strong in that situation.
Cleveland Melvin's third personal foul. For DePaul, that's team foul number 4. That's going to be team foul number 5 as Marchuk picks up the personal, trying to stay in front of Collier.
It's like they're working on his knee right there. And believe me, a veteran of 2 knee surgeries, you don't want that. You want those wheels to feel okay, especially the way he's playing this afternoon.
Tommy Hamilton back into the game, replacing Marchuch. Marchuch with 3 personal fouls.
This young man's gonna have to really pick it up here. Oregon State not having a lot of success on the defensive end. So Craig Robinson gonna change things up. Trying to face guard on the inbounds here. DePaul's not recognizing it.
Garrett, McDonald, Hamilton, Crockett, and Melvin, the 5 on the floor for DePaul. This is Hamilton, spins, hangs, and hits!
Tommy Hamilton showing you he's got some skills in his repertoire. And now being asked to guard Collier on this end, see how he responds to the challenge.
Poked out of bounds by Crockett. 24 seconds on the shot clock for Oregon State.
Watch this spin, bump, hang, touch. Tommy Hamilton showing you why DePaul's excited to have that talented freshman.
Robbins, the pull-up, made that with Crockett all over him. First 2 points for Victor Robbins, sophomore out of Compton, California.
Oh boy, Compton, I could have a whole lot of music references right there, but gonna let that one go.
McDonald keeps the dribble alive, pull up from the free throw line. One and done, one-handed rebound for Collier. Duvivier gets inside, he's fouled.
And Oliver Purnell has a look of disgust on his face with McDonald's choice of shot selection right there. Just forced the issue. And when you do that, Eric, your team is off balance defensively, and that's why Duvivier has an opportunity right now.
Malcolm Duvivier, freshman out of Toronto, Ontario.
You say that like you enjoy saying his name. Say it again, Eric.
Malcolm Duvivier. McDonald goes to the bench and has a conversation, probably a one-way conversation with Oliver Purnell.
So tough for coaches a lot of times to express to players each and every possession is critical. And they look up and they're 13 points ahead, but any one play can turn the tide in a game.
Garrett is fouled. He'll go to the free throw line and shoot two. Steven, big picture question for you. Is this the way the game is going to be all season long? DePaul with 70 points, still with 9 minutes left to play. Are we talking about games that are consistently going to be played in the 80s and 90-point range?
I mean, it would be good to see. I doubt it because the emphasis on the defensive end for most teams that DePaul is going to play is going to be stronger than what Oregon State typically shows you. Last in field goal percentage defense in the Pac-12 last season was Oregon State. So this is a team that doesn't hang their hat on the defensive end and thus giving up a lot of points to DePaul.
DePaul scored all of 59 points their last time they played on Tuesday in Kansas City against the Texas Longhorns. Okay, big point in today's game. Roberto Nelson back on the floor playing with four personal fouls.
So at this juncture of the game, Craig Robinson knows 15 down. I got to give it a shot to try to get back in the ball game. But you got to get Roberto Nelson off the basketball.
Great backdoor cut. Brandt finds the streaking Robbins for two. 4 points now for Victor Robbins.
A little Princeton offense wrinkle that time. Dribble to the player. The player goes backdoor. No help side defensively.
Melvin inside off the window.
Woo, that was a grown man move right there. Cleveland Melvin. It's like, give me the rock. I cannot be stopped.
Melvin, one of four Blue Demons in double figures. Melvin's got 18. Trailing only Brandon Young, who's got 19. And a rip away. Marchuch hands it over to Brandon Young. Weaving inside, throws it up wildly. And he's called for the travel, and he's down in pain.
Like he does such a good job, Eric, of drawing contact. It looks like he got tangled up. Let's take a look right. Ooh, that left ankle rolled hard.
It's been a tough last 5 or 6 minutes for Brandon Young.
It looked like he hurt his knee the previous time. And this time, rolled that ankle.
Young's had a real nice day. 19 points, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists.
So now, who's going to, looks like McDonald's going to have the task of trying to guard Roberto Nelson. And doesn't have as many career games under his belt as Brandon Young does.
Robbins is fouled.
Boy, Victor Robbins, a bouncy 6'6 athlete. He's made some really good plays here in the last couple minutes for Oregon State.
Well, we've got a timeout on the floor. Cleveland Melvin, the senior for DePaul, trying to will the Blue Demons back into the win column. finish your weekend with a terrific doubleheader. We've got the 16th-ranked North Carolina Tar Heels taking on the UAB Blazers, followed by the 3rd-ranked Kentucky Wildcats and the Providence Friars, two legendary teams coming to Fox Sports 1, and it all starts tonight, 6 p.m. Eastern, only on America's new 24-hour sports network. Brandon Young has got that shoe off being looked at.
So they're going to try to retape it so he can get back in the game. And when you have that.